Today I went down to the lake to check on the ice, and I found that it would be long before I could do any test sailing on my new sail. The lake was covered with ice, open only where the stream exits. Otherwise, about 15 centimeters thick. Perfect conditions for an ice boat. So I returned to the garage with an idea to build one, hoping the conditions would be the same when I had finished. I planned to use some leftover metal as sliders and shape them to not get stuck on unevenness in the ice. The steering plate in both ends, as I thought it would make turning easier. With an angle grinder, I cut out the profile. Some trimming of the edge. If there would be some snow on the ice, it might be good with a bigger angle support piece. So I cut two. On the other side, I would use plywood as support. Just need to figure out how to cut it. I want the same uplifting effect on this side as well. So I cut one and use it as a mold for the second one. These are for the two front sliders. The steering slide would have just two plywood support sides. The front sliders would need to be separated to provide side stability for the ice boat. Two 1 meter long pieces will do. Now I start dry fitting the pieces. I use small screws as most of the load will be taken by epoxy. To find the holes in the hole plate, I first screw in the screws from the opposite direction, before I screw them through from the intended direction. I think this could slide through quite nice. On the steering plate, I need room for a bolt to turn around, so I add a second layer for the bolt. There might be too much local weight on the bottom, so I shape some leftovers from the kayak build to make a support for the steering blade. It is only laminated on one side, so I add a second layer. Then I mix up some epoxy to glue the things together. The epoxy gets better mixed if you add the cotton fibers last. Some squeeze out comes out as I screw the plates together. I want to completely saturate the surface before bonding. And glass is hard to wet out if you don't have any saturated layer. I let the glass cure to shape using some plastic in between. After clean cutting it, it will be a perfect cross support. Now the cross beams. Also these are dry fitted, to see that all fits before the second batch of epoxy is prepared. If you're not prepared, you will run out of time. I think I will need side supports, so I measure the angle to the keel using a measuring stick and cut some pieces to use as side support. I I face these to fit the angle of the kayak side. For both bottom cross beams. To have something to tie straps through, I cut some holes. A couple in each side support. This way I will fit them. The thinking through on the steering blade is less finished. Perhaps I can build an eye bulk as a rudder post. I need a large plate as a turning plate, but also some way to attach the steering to the kayak. This turns out to be complicated. If I make the fitting as long as the joining zone, I might use the joining screws as a holder for the steering. So I cut a suitable piece to connect the two and shape another piece as a crossbeam and drill holes in it for the joining screws. One layer, two layers, three layers, and the screws should go through. Some drilling later, and I can test fit the connector. Time for the second batch of epoxy. Now the temperature has dropped outside, so I have to use the heater to reach 20 degrees in the garage. I do one set of pieces at a time. When cured, epoxy is stronger than wood, as you will see later. But now it's soft as melted ice cream, and it can be smeared easily. And you need clamps to hold it in place, or screws. In the joinings, I add some glass. This will make the joining tougher. After curing, I can inspect the result and start fitting the pieces together. I notice some problem areas that need to be adjusted. Things seldom turns out the way you thought. Building without plans is a constant iteration. Now the screws should be long enough at least. And I continue to discover new challenges. Okay, it turns, but does it turn well? This bolt is the next problem. There is not enough room for the hull in between. I have glued two pieces together that should not have been joined. And now you get to see how strong epoxy is. After striking it all around on both sides, it gives in. But as you can see, it is the wood that has given in, not the epoxy. Now I can mount the steering. Fasten it with the joining screws. Connecting the holder. Inserting the cross support. And screwing the bolt. The front piece is just clean cut, and we can test the ride. That will be in the next episode. Thank you for watching. Hope to see you next time.